so that will prevent your jewels from vibrating. Hello friends, so today's video is going to be an overview and a review about the RX100. I know that I have not been doing an English video for some time. That is purely because of the lack of time at my end. I have been working with new projects at office and that has kept me very busy. So today I thought that, you know, I will break that couple of months of hibernation on English videos and do an English video. So today we are going to do an overview and a review of my RX100. So this RX100 is a 1989 model and it has been in the family since new. So this bike was owned by my cousin brother and I took this bike from him almost 12 years ago. So we'll talk about the bike. The bike is a Japanese bike and, you know, this is my primary bike. This is the bike I use to go everywhere, so it has a lot of kilometers. Other than that, I haven't used this bike for long rides, but I have taken one long ride in this in around 2013-14, I believe, and you know, that was the longest I've taken. So I'll talk about all the aspects of this bike one by one and we'll start from the front. So this is my primary bike, and because of which it sees a lot of dirt, sees a lot of puddles in the road, so it is kind of dirty, right? So what we will do is we will start with washing the bike first, and once the bike is washed, then we will get into the actual review. Okay, so we are going to start from the front. Many of you who are the old gen subscribers might know that my RX100 had alloy wheels in the front and back. The reason for putting alloy wheels are because, you know, there are a lot of potholes in the area that I live in, and sometimes these wheels can get bent. I'm talking about these spokes wheels. So in order to prevent any type of maintenance, I fitted them with alloy wheels, but most of you folks didn't like that. So what I did is I reverted to the OE setup. So these wheels actually came in the RXZ that I bought from Kashmir, my old RXZ, which is now blue in color. So what I did is I just swapped those. So at that time it didn't have this kind of a rusting. So I'll show you the reason why it rusts like this. Okay, so we have to replace those. So that is in my bucket list. But since you saw why these wheels go bad quickly. You will see, especially the front wheels in all my bikes are gone. Okay, so because of that, I don't know, but anyhow, that is in the plan. Maybe I might get these wheels powder coated in some other color like black or something, and then, you know, install it so that this problem which I showed you earlier doesn't occur again. Okay, so the forks on this RX100 are from the 5-speed, because I converted the 5-speed into disc brake using Gladiator setup, so I had those lying around. So initially they were buffed, so what we did is we actually just left them as is and installed those forks here. So right now it is running perfectly fine, has new oil seals and everything, so we are good in terms of that. But when I'm getting the wheels done, I'll also get the forks painted, because they kind of look very tired, especially in the dull metal buffed finish that it is in. So the mudguard, so this mudguard is an original RX 100-135 type mudguard. So after it was plated, it's been about 6-7 months, so you can see it has started developing rust again. So the reason why that happens is because the acid which they use to strip the plating, the old plating, kind of, you know, gets stuck in crevices. And then if you can, then also I would suggest that you paint the underside very properly, so that, you know, there is a difference between company plating and the second aftermarket plating. So company plating can withstand a lot of abuse, so if you get a mudguard in the company plating, that is the way to go. It will clean out nicely, then you're good. So, you know, keep your plating intact, don't, you know, change it. Then the next thing is, earlier the Crux mudguard were available, so, you know, we used to actually buy those. The difference between the Crux and RX mudguard is this particular hole. There were two holes in the Crux mudguard, but the RX has only one hole, so that is another thing. Then this number plate is the original RX type number plate. On top of it, I have fixed the IND number plate. So in my RC book, it was KL2289, but when we were getting it retested recently, we had to add a zero because they asked us to. So I add some space here, so we added that zero there. Then the next thing is the dome. So the dome is an H4 conversion. So for an H4 conversion, you need a reflector from a DCM Toyota, and you need the connector for the bulb from a Bullet, because this reflector is little bigger than the OE reflector, so it might not stay properly or fit properly in this kind of a dome. So you might need either the last model dome, or you need to get Bullet and Enfield Bullet type connectors. The last model dome I won't recommend, because the speedometer is on this side, so there is no guide for the cable behind. So what happens is it breaks the cable pretty frequently, so if you can avoid that, do that. Then we have the indicators. These are aftermarket Minda indicators. That's what we get today. So these are like 1.5-2 years old, so looking pretty tired. So yeah, that is one thing. Next, we should talk about these pilot lamps. These pilot lamps are original. These were installed in 2013. They have aged well for the time. This speedometer is from a 135. When I needed a speedometer, I had only this option. So instead of, you know, waiting for a couple of weeks to get the RX100 type speedometer, I got this. But I have both the Nippon Psyche and the Rajdoot speedometer. I have a small speedometer collection. We will talk about that on a different day. Okay, next is the ignition key. So we have the metal ignition key. So this is a very important thing that I'm going to talk about right now. So what happens is, people usually sell you the ignition lock kit with this kind of a key for anywhere between 1500 to 2000 rupees, and the charge for the OE lock is around 500 to 600. I don't remember the exact price now. So those comes with half plastic keys. So what you can do is, you can go to any key shop, and they have these Yamaha Minda type metal key blank keys available, and you can get these two keys cut for almost like 150 bucks. So let's say you spend 600 for the lock and 150, so that is still 750. Imagine paying 1500 to 2000 rupees for this lock set. So people do play games with you, so be very careful. So now you have learned something new, so don't pay extra for those locks with metal keys. You can get them made. That's what those people also do, so do that. So next is, the handle is from an RD350. Levers are original RX levers, which I got plated so that it matches the look. Then this is an RX 100-135 4-speed type switch, so we have retained that. Cables, the clutch cable especially needs a replacement. The brake cable and throttle cable are reasonably new, so is the speedometer cable. So these are reasonably, yeah, that's about the front. Quickly talk about the wiring. The wiring kit is new in this. It's a 12 volt system. I'll talk about that system in a while. Handle cover from a 135 installed. If you remove this, kind of looks ugly, so that is the reason why we installed this. That will actually ensure that looks decent. So I'm pretty lazy to get these threaded and install the screw, so that is going to happen pretty soon. I have a small bend in the T-stem, so I went to the shop to buy a new tank, and only this one tank was available, and it has a small deficiency. It here there is a small ding, and this was, I bought this at a very good price. This was an original tank, not like the cheap Delhi ones which you have now, which has suitable for Yamaha sticker, you know. This is an original Yamaha tank, and it's pretty rare. So I just got it. I thought, okay, I'll paint it in the gray color, the Hyundai i10 gray, to match the side covers, and I just fixed it on the bike, and the way it looked, I was like, I have to do justice to this. So I just retained the tank in the same color for a very long time. The covers were gray and the tank was blue, and I was contemplating, should I paint this blue or should I paint that gray, and finally I decided to retain the blue color. This is in the RC as well. Those side covers got painted in blue. The RX100 monogram that you see there is original. The oil level gauge that you see is original. I have a few of them lying, but don't worry, nothing is for sale. These things, you don't get them original anymore, so the ones which are available keep bad quality. So this was changed, I think, a year and a half ago. It has shown us two true colors, so I think I'll have to replace that. Next, we'll move on to the seat. So the seat, some of you has commented that the seat doesn't look that great, but that's not true, because this is the original shape of RX100 seat. I had an original RX100 old stock seat lying with me for reference, which is still in my storage. I don't intend to use it anytime. So what I did is searched a lot of places in Trivandrum, and finally I shortlisted my seat guy, and who has done multiple seats for me. This guy, apart from my RD350, any builds that I do, any bikes that I do, this guy does my seat. This material, the Rexin on top, is a little softer than what used to come from Yamaha. That was a hard material, like a PVC plastic material, but this is little plush, and because of which, you know, it doesn't get hard over a period of time and doesn't fade away. So this guy has done a brilliant job in, you know, shaping this and stitching it. I would say this is, you know, 99.95% accurate. I will just take 1% for the way the Yamaha logo looks, otherwise this is perfect. I wanted a belt across it, so he has done that. So this seat is absolutely perfect for me. Next is the carrier. The carrier is not an original carrier, this is an aftermarket carrier. If you see, there are two rivet marks. So this was a Delhi carrier which I retained on this bike. This bike is my daily, and this thing is pretty useful. So you can put a lot of stuff here. So this is functional, not just for looks. The tail light is original Alpha Toyo. The mudguard, rear mudguard, is original, replaced in 2013, has absolutely no rust. The mud flaps were also replaced at that time. So since we are talking about accessories, we'll talk about this guy. So I don't know, many of you might not have seen sari guard like this. So this is an original Rajdoot accessory that used to come in the good old days. This sari guard was fitted from the company by my brother. I have retained that sari guard. Many people have reached out to me, or wherever I go, people ask me if I am ready to sell the sari guard. So you need to understand how important and rare this is. You know, you can see it on the bike, so obviously I have said no to everybody. This sari guard was plated recently but has started rusting, and this is my only bike which has a sari guard, because this is the only bike which my wife loves. You know, she won't let me sell this bike. She will be okay if I sell the RD350, she'll be okay if I sell the RXZ, Shaolin, or any bike that I have, but this particular bike she won't let me sell, because the story behind it, my wife kind of fell in love with this bike, taken both of us to a lot of places, and both of us enjoy going around in this bike. Rear rim, like I said, needs replacement, so we'll replace that as well. The tire is 318. The chain cover actually needs to be painted, because when I painted the engine cover, now the chain cover is kind of sticking out like a sore thumb, so I'll replace, rather paint those as well. Then it's about the shocks. So these are the shocks which originally came in the bike, so I haven't touched them. They are not short, but they are not very comfortable. I'm contemplating either getting platina type shocks, or maybe see if other options are available, but I will try to stick to a look which would be very, very, very close to stock. I'm not going to change it drastically. So that's about the shock. The chassis doesn't have any welds or any issues. It's perfect. How do you check? The chassis is perfect and straight. Put it in the center stand and see if the bike rocks like this. So we have, you know, detailed this in what to look for while buying an RX100, RX135. So go check out that bike. We'll go to the engine next. So before the engine, the problem with this bike was a 6 volt to 12 volt convert. Okay, so this is an 89 model. You can see there is a made in Japan written here. It was a 6 volt bike which we got converted to 12 volt. The light or the lighting of the bike was not something that I was very proud of, or that was not something which was very confidence inspiring. So I started looking for options. So my first option was to, you know, get the coil winded. So I did that. We also changed bulb to an H4 kind. I have just spoken about how you
do that. And then what happened is finally we came across this Allied. So I just wanted to check with Mr. Rahman if he would just sell me stator and the magnet alone and I'll use the kit. So he said that you need to try the kit once. So that's how I got the entire thing. I bought it with my own money. We installed it in this bike. The rest is history. So the moment I installed it in the bike started behaving very differently. It was very different kind of a power that I experienced in this. The front wheel was kind of little, you know, happy to get lifted from the ground. My problem started because this engine was built around 2010. It started leaking from places. So what I did is I changed the oil seals and everything. When I took apart the engine, I also knew that it is a sleeve cylinder. I also thought, okay, I'll do that. So overall engine was rebuilt. All the bearings are new. All the oil seals are new. New piston, new connecting rod in the crank. The crank was completely rebuilt. Everything painted. The cylinder was rebored to 1mm. Though this was a 0.25, but it had rust inside, so we had to rebore it to 1mm. Everything else was done. And the bike is right now in the running in period. I have run the bike around 300 kilometers roughly post rebuild. One, because of lockdown. Two, because I don't ride the bike much. I usually prefer taking the car because of our family being bigger and, you know, car is, you know, better because, you know, Kerala, you can see everything is wet. That is because there was a rain just a couple of minutes ago. Either it rains or it is very sunny. So car is more practical. So I haven't ridden the bike much. So it is still in running in period. So I can't tell you how powerful it is, but I will tell you what I did a couple of months ago. So one day I was riding this bike. It was around 200 kilometers odd in running in. So I thought, okay, I'll do one pull. So I started doing the pull and somewhere around 100 kilometers per hour, it started sounding as if it is about to seize. So I pulled the clutch, brought the bike to a halt, turned it off, stayed for 5 minutes, and then I again took the bike. So after that, I have decided that I am not going to pull any stunt till the running in period is over. So that's the reason why I don't know how performance or how powerful it is, but it is a fun to drive bike now. Before the rebuild, there was a flutter at high rev. I was suggested to change the carburetor since it is running in. I have not touched that, as you guys know the story behind the silencer. So yeah, next is how the bike sounds. Then we will talk about what I like in the bike and what I don't. Okay, so the Yamaha RX-100 was the bread and butter model, the Escort Yamaha group. This was the bike that actually, you know, made some decent amount of revenue for them because this was the only bike that Yamaha sold which was successful. All the bikes were not as successful as this. They put a lot of effort in this. A lot of things were amazing in this. So I'll tell you what are the things that I like about this bike. First of all is the riding position. Even with the stock handle, the riding position is pretty upright. You won't feel that tired if you're going for a long ride, but there is a caveat to that and I'll get to that in a minute. So the riding position is what I like. The bike is very nimble. It is small, so you can easily flick it, you know, be a squid. This bike has an excellent low end response, and the low end is what RX-100s are known for. So in traffic, if you get to ride an RX-100 and an RX-135, you will definitely pick a RX-100 because that is how different it is in the traffic. But on highway, the story is slightly different. We'll come to that. This has the same 4-speed gearbox which the 135 has, so no differences there. When you ride this bike continuously at a high speed for long drive, first is your fingers get tingly because it is a 2-stroke. There is a lot of vibration towards the high end. Then second thing is if you're resting your jewels on the tank, your jewels will also become very tingly. So that is another funny thing on this. So I won't prefer this for a long drive because it causes a lot of tingles especially. So another thing that you can do to improve that long speed ride is you can get a gel pad and sit on that. So that will prevent your jewels from vibrating heavily. For the fingers, I've heard that riding gloves help. So I don't ride much, so I don't have much of riding gear except for a helmet. That is another. Third thing is the mileage. In the Yamaha 100 135cc, this is not a mileage friendly bike. I get like 24-25 kilometers per liter. I've not calculated, but that's an approximation. It has the original Mikuni carburetor, but if you get the Mikarb carburetor, it will give you more mileage, and since the torque is all at the low end, you won't feel much of a performance difference if you put the Mikuni carburetor. But yes, mileage will slightly, mileage wise it's not a great guy to be. This thing doesn't overheat any other air cooled bike. That is another thing. You can go non-stop on this, doesn't cause a problem. Okay, now the comfort of the bike is slightly low because this is almost a 34-35 year old bike. You cannot expect it to be very plush. For small rides, this is fun, of a different kind that you won't get in a four stroke, maybe even a 200 plus cc four stroke, because the power is immediate, not like four stroke. You know, for some time there is nothing and all of a sudden you get, it's not like that. So it's very linear and very nice. Those are the two aspects. The best ignition system that came in a Yamaha two stroke bike in India is in the RX 100, so that was an amazing ignition system. But the one that I replaced is not a compromise. It is also performance wise good. I have felt that the front becomes little happy and you know, you can lift it, there is ample power, but since it is in running in mode, I'm not pushing it. So yeah, that's the overview, performance as running aspect. Day to day, on a daily basis, you can use an RX 100. If your commute is between, let's say, 25 to 30 kilometers per day, anything above that I won't recommend it, because an RX 135 will be better than this, because the vibrations can make you tired, especially at the age that I am in. But yeah, it's a good bike to even own today. So what do you need to look for if you're buying an RX 100 is something that we have covered in the past, so go check out that video. We have covered almost everything. Now what is pending on the bike? Obviously both the rims, both the hubs needs to be painted. The rear, the chain cover needs to be painted, because once I painted the side covers, the chain covers kind of stick out now like a sore thumb, so we need to paint that. Mudguard, maybe we need to plate it again. Mirrors, both mirrors need changing. Then there is one nut missing under the seat, so I have to fix that. All four indicators need change. The flasher unit needs change. Gear lever needs change. The footrest rubbers need to change. Other than that, I don't think there is any other issue. The wiring is perfect. The bike runs well. Everything is awesome. So I would say under 3000. Rims, new spoke, hubs, everything. Painting is something that I can do, so not to worry that. If I have 3000 rupees and if I spend it on this bike will be as good as new. I don't like to spend that money now, because this is my daily, and the reason why the rims get rusted, you have seen that happens with every bike of mine. The RD350 is sitting on the brand new rims and that have started rusting because of these two super duper guys in my house. And that's about. So I hope this video was informative. We'll come up with more videos, and again apologies for not uploading an English video, and we'll see you guys in the next one. Bye bye.